Hello, good morning everyone. Today we are going to see Operating System Unit 2 Session 3. In the previous topic, we have studied various process states, which is a very important topic. Based on these various process states, there are CPU scheduling algorithms, and it is also important from exam point of view because more questions will be based on this Unit 2 process management. And in today's topic, we'll study process schedulers. So what is the work of the process schedulers? So the responsibility of the process schedulers is to select the processes and move it from one state to another state. So whether it is a new state, ready state or running state. So the scheduler's job is to select the processes and move it to another state. So schedulers are special system software. They help in scheduling the processes in various ways. They are mainly responsible for selecting the jobs, that is processes, and submit it into the system and decide which process to run. So where these schedulers will be working? So schedulers will be working between these various states. So where some of the schedulers works from between new state to ready state, some of the scheduler work between ready state to running state, some of the schedulers work between running state to waiting state. That means to select the processes and move it from one state to another state. The first scheduler we'll see, long-term scheduler. It is also called as job scheduler. So what is the responsibility of long-term scheduler? Responsible for creating new processes and select which processes should be brought up into the ready queue. So as I told you in the previous session, there is a CPU, then we have main memory, and then we have secondary memory. So all the programs will be residing in the secondary memory. So your programs will be residing in the secondary memory. So the long-term scheduler picks the programs and bring it to the main memory for execution. So when they are brought to the main memory for execution, those are under process creation, and those are for time being in the new state. When the processes are created, the long-term scheduler moves them to the ready state. So the long-term scheduler selects the processes and brings them to the main memory. And after process creation, sends them to the ready state. Long-term scheduler controls the degree of multiprogramming. That is number of processes present in main memory. See here, as I told you, the processes will be brought from new state to ready state by the long-term scheduler. Now, the long-term scheduler also has the authority to how many processes should be brought up to the ready queue. That is called as degree of multiprogramming. So, if there are more number of processes waiting in the ready queue, then it reduces the speed to bring the processes in the ready queue. And if there are less number of processes in the ready queue, it can also increase the speed to bring the processes in the ready queue. So how much processes should be brought up to the ready queue, that is in the main memory, will be decided by the long-term scheduler. Processes can be described as either input-output bound processes, that is spends more time doing input-output than computations, many short CPU bursts. Next is CPU bound process, spends more time doing computations, few very long CPU bursts. So whenever the long-term scheduler brings the processes in the ready queue, It brings the mixture of input-output processes and CPU-bound processes. Input-output processes means, so these are the processes which will be using the input-output resources. Those will be using more input-output resources. Whereas CPU processes are those which will be using more computations, CPU burst. Means it will spend more time in using CPU computations and all. And whereas input-output processes spends more time in doing, using resources. So whenever the long-term scheduler brings the processes in the ready queue, in the main memory, it will bring the mixture of some of the processes will be input-output bound processes, some of the processes will be CPU-bound processes. So long-term scheduler is responsible to bring mixture of both processes. Next we'll see short-term scheduler. It is also called as CPU scheduler. So this is also very important scheduler of our operating system, which select, see which process should be executed next and allocates to CPU. Yes. So which process is given the chance to execute and which process should be allocated to the CPU, this will be done by the short-term scheduler. So where those will be used? Yes. So the short-term schedulers will be used between ready queue to running state. Okay. Now, already the processes are waiting in the ready queue. So the processes will be selected based on the CPU scheduling algorithms. The short-term scheduler selects the processes and send it to the CPU for execution. So this is the responsibility of short-term scheduler. Based on the CPU scheduling algorithm, it will select the processes and it will send it to the CPU for execution. Sometimes the scheduler, the only scheduler in a system, short-term scheduler is invoked frequently, milliseconds, must be fast, as the short-term scheduler working is very fast because it has to select the processes and immediately they have to send it to the CPU for execution. So it should be very active. Bringing processes from ready state to running state is the responsibility of the short-term scheduler. Next one we'll see medium-term scheduler. So medium-term scheduler are responsible for suspending and resuming the processes. It is called swapper. So whenever there is no memory in the main memory, that means there are too many processes waiting in the ready queue. Then or some of the processes wants to use the resources and resources are not available. So instead of waiting in the ready queue, such processes will be sent to the ready suspended, and that will be done by the medium term scheduler. That will be done by medium term scheduler. That is sending the processes from main memory to secondary. Sending the processes from main memory to secondary memory. So here also, now when the processes are waiting for input output, such processes will be sent to secondary memory, that is in a block suspended, and that will be done by the MTS, moving the processes from main memory to secondary memory. And when there is a memory in the ready queue, then again those processes will be brought up to the main memory by the medium term scheduler. And here also, when the resources are available, then the waiting processes will be again brought up to the main memory for execution. So remove processes from main memory and store it in disk, secondary disk, and bring back in main memory from disk to continue execution. Medium term scheduler can be added if degree of multiprogramming needs to decrease. Yes. If there are too many processes waiting in the ready suspended state, or a block suspended state, then it can reduce the degree of bringing the processes in that state. So there are three types of schedulers: long-term scheduler, short-term scheduler, and medium-term scheduler. So long-term scheduler brings the processes from new state to ready state, and short-term scheduler selects the processes from ready state to and send it to running state. So this will be done by short-term scheduler. And also, to send the processes from running state to waiting state to use the resources will be done by short-term scheduler. And when the main memory is full, means lot of processes are waiting there, to send the processes from ready state to ready suspended state will be done by medium-term scheduler. That is, and when the memory is available, space is available, there are not too much processes, again the waiting processes will be sent back to the ready state. Same here, the processes which are waiting for resources, and if the resources are busy, then those processes will be sent to the blocked suspended state, that is from main memory to secondary memory. And also, if the resources are available, those will be sent back from block suspended state to waiting state, and this will be done by the medium term scheduler. So we have completed this session. In the next session, we'll see various possibilities of the states, how the process moves from one state to another state, and what are the various possibilities. Thank you.